All right, welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be watching You Season 3, Episode 3. Now, in the last episode, so we went to couples therapy. It seemed like that was successful. The love is back in the air. Seems like Joe's feelings for love are back. I don't know how long it's going to last. I'm curious to see if that's going to be consistent. But also, the cage is back. They put the cage in the basement of the bakery. I don't see it going well. I think they're going to eventually trap Theo, the neighbor, Natalie's husband, Matthew, their son, because their son's trying to fuck on love. I think he's going to end up being in the cage. I think that's going to be the first person they put in the cage of the season. So, and also, even though I said the love is back, Joe's love is back, he still doesn't trust her. He hid a key in the cage. He hid a key in the cage. That tells us right there, just in case he's trapped in there, he can still get out. You know, if love traps him in there, he can get out. But love also did the same thing. She also hid a key in the cage too, just in case if he puts her in the cage, she can get out. That kind of tells you where the trust levels are at. Not very high, to be honest. So does that really mean love's back in the air? Joe's really in love with love again? I don't know. His actions speak louder than his words. You know, he's telling us he is, but the fact that he put the key, he hid a spare key in there, just in case, I don't know. I don't trust it. I'm excited to see what happens, so I'm gonna stop wasting time. We're just gonna hop right into this episode. If you'd like to watch the full length reaction, that'll be available on Patreon, as well as early access to the next two episodes of You will also be available on Patreon and YouTube membership. Click the join button down below. So anyways, let's get started.
Home for work. Her vehicle was found outside a rental cabin near Redwood State Park.
You ready, sweetie?
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Sherry. It's all fake, dude.
Ryan Goodwin, Channel 3 News.
You got it. Every day it's the same fucking story.
He's like that one news reporter, like that one famous video where he's just like cussing out. He's cussing out.
That led to Chris Wood's death.
The fuck is that? I'm dying in this fucking country ass fucked up town.
You are worried your previous mistakes were cleaned up by the family fixer. He's to deal with when they've all been paid off.
Yep, not this time.
How can he be so calm?
Experience tried killing a celebrity comedian without a fixer.
Yep, I was just about to say experience.
A close call, we fixed it. We talked to the cops.
Is there anything you can tell us about Natalie Engler or her relationship with her husband, Matthew Engler?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're gonna blame it on the husband. Say some bad stuff about Matthew. So it looks like he did it.
We don't really know them.
I would have sneaked in some bad things about Matthew, blame it on him. Because they're already asking about him. They're already suspicious about him.
He's innocent, but he's acting guilty. That's strange, but...
I feel like he's just a weirdo.
For us, if he goes down for this, then we're free and clear.
Make that thing again, like when you wanted to frame Ellie for killing Hendy, you feel trapped and it's clouding your judgment.
Like if nobody finds the body, people will eventually assume she ran off.
We take care of Henry. I'll keep us safe, I promise.
I believe that.
Crying for the camera isn't for everyone, fine, but he's just working. Know why I'm acting normal right now, but why is he? Fuck.
Sure, the husband did it.
You have to watch out for husbands. Ray would love to have me killed. You know that's if I don't have him killed first.
She's talking about, like the therapist said, husbands and wives want to kill each other, but they'll never actually do it. Sherry's gonna come in here acting like she gives a fuck about Natalie.
Thanks for asking, but we're here as concerned citizens. We started a committee to find Natalie Engler. We don't even know if anything bad happened.
Matter of time. Oh my god, have you seen the Tracy Paulson murder document? Always the husband.
Always.
See, it's like they're doing a selfless act out of the most selfish motivation.
Before, you know.
This must be so difficult for you.
Thank you.
Dude, I feel like love's just gonna snap on Sherry. Like, love can only take it for so long.
Seems incredibly important to you.
Oh my god, it's my number one priority.
Oh my god.
Closest friend.
She hated her.
We all loved her.
I fucking hate Sherry, dude.
It was lease a space for a bakery for her next door neighbor. She lives right over there.
Did Sherry Conrad just tell the entire world that one of the last people who saw the missing white woman was my wife?
Hi. Yeah, absolutely. What can I do for you, detective?
Fuck me.
God damn it. All right. Oh, I mean, of course the detective's gonna come by. You're the neighbor, so. Normal.
Security footage of you two chatting in a grocery store parking lot 2 days before she vanished.
Sweating. I need to get it together.
You're losing your edge. You never would have sweated in the past.
They don't suspect me. They are just doing their job. I need to stop sweating.
You're folding, Joe. The old you would never have folded.
Look, the thing is, Natalie has a very weird sense of humor.
Wait, that's not a terrible idea.
I wasn't going to say this, but I think I need to come clean. There's nowhere for a man to enjoy himself, if you understand what I'm saying.
Strongly advise you to not do that anymore.
Yeah. Isn't that illegal?
Masturbation saves the day for now.
God damn.
And oh, look at this. We got Madre Linda's newest baking.
Stop fucking filming me.
Are you?
I'm making an ironic TikTok.
Oh my god, TikTok.
Yep, it's deleted.
I'm just having a bad hair day.
Looks pretty good to me.
Stop that.
Stop what?
Stop flirting.
Also, the story of why I forgot my wallet.
Sorry, shit ain't free.
Now I am gonna die starving and destitute. Unless you were to.
Unless you were to go get a fucking job.
Flirting with you. I'm begging you for food. My lady and savior.
Carrot or chai walnut?
Carrot, please.
This is your first and your last free cupcake ever, okay? Never ask me again.
It's like fail a secret personality test or something.
Oh, no.
No, you're just annoying.
And I used to make it all the time for my brother when he would, when he came around.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. Are you fucking kidding me?
Bro, you didn't even give it a quarter of a second to decide if you like it or not. You just decided it was good before you even, like, come on, dude.
How are you holding up? Do you have people that you can talk to? I wasn't trying to pry. I'm so, Mom?
I mean, he might be going through his own stuff, too. You know, probably has no one to talk to.
My God. Okay. Yes, I'm on my way.
He might be flirting with love, but he's also trying to make a friend, too, at the end of the day.
My baby is sick.
Oh, shit.
Be with your baby.
Yeah, there's a spare key in the drawer.
Hey, okay, spare key in the drawer.
Yeah.
Guess we just hired him. He's probably gonna work here now.
There.
What if there were more cameras? What if she lied to me, her boring neighbor? What if Matthew is building a case against me this mission?
Joe, I'm at the hospital. Henry has the measles.
He'll be fine. Every kid gets the measles, but he's like a newborn, so.
A finger been locked in a cage, but in my history of scared.
Yeah.
Is the most scared I've ever been.
That nurse has been gone an awfully long time. I took a look at his blood work, and he was infected about a week ago.
How? I mean, I thought the measles were eradicated.
Even in the age of COVID, there are parents who refuse to have their children vaccinated.
Fever?
Cough, runny nose, general discomfort. Now, in severe cases, hearing loss, possible seizures.
Medicine?
For the fever. Otherwise, it has to run its course.
Yeah, when something bad happens to you, it's scary. But when it happens to, like, your child, it's the worst fucking thing in the world.
You know, since we were all at Hudson's birthday party last week.
Oh my god.
I'm so sorry.
Oh my god.
Dude, wait, are the measles, like, worse than I thought they were? I thought it was, like, something like the chicken pox, you know? Where it's like, that sucks, but he'll be fine, you know? I guess it's worse than I thought.
Hirabelle loves baby.
Oh my god, no, what happened?
My heart is breaking for them.
She doesn't give a fuck.
I hope your friends weren't too upset with you.
Why were you on the phone?
I'm buying a vineyard.
Oh, I thought we didn't have money. I thought we were...
This is a once in a lifetime.
Wow.
Your bakery will be fine. You'll figure it out.
Wow. Thanks. I mean, at least the bakery's already open and it's already running.
I came here to get a fresh start and you followed me here and brought all your toxic garbage with you.
Is this retribution for my sins?
Probably. Karma's a bitch.
Get better. Just get better, and I promise to be a man worthy of raising you.
So, cops are asking you questions, and my name and business are on the news. I think acting normal isn't working. We need to do something.
You're right, Matthew's a threat.
Ooh.
Everybody already thinks that he did something to her. We should frame him. I was just trying to...
How?
We'll figure it out.
Natalie's scarf with her blood on it. I only kept it for insurance.
Okay, perfect. Perfect. All right, I just Googled the measles. Yeah, they're pretty fucking serious. All right, so my bad. Especially for children under 5. It's pretty serious.
Ooh, okay.
Oh, Joe has the measles.
Thought I was sweating because I'm guilty.
Yeah. I was just about to say, that's why he's sweating so much.
I came on fast. I gotta get to Matthew's house. I gotta plant the scarf.
Nah, you can't.
Breathing, girl. I gotta do this. Don't fall over.
Nah, you're not making it.
You sure about that?
His demon came out.
Oh, he has cameras. Now I told you the one outside is broken. Look, if you're worried, pop a hoodie on. You look just like Matthew's douchebag kid. It's almost like you anticipated needing it all along.
Shut up.
Fuck. Oh, he's back at the child home. Ooh, oh. Okay, that was him hopping the fence.
Yeah. In front of the other. Where's Henry?
Did you get vaccinated, Joe?
Ooh.
You know, I noticed that we don't have any record of your vaccinations.
Hmm.
To get a shot?
Yeah, of course. We lost a record or something, but
never got it. So you passed the measles on to Henry. Ooh. Watch, it's actually Matthew choking him. Because he's in the backyard right now.
Hey, look at me.
Oh shit. No, he's not choking him. He's just,
I think. This is real?
Yeah.
What were you doing in my backyard?
Oh, fuck.
Fuck. Fuck. Fuck.
Yeah, because he started hallucinating in the backyard or whatever. And he has a scarf on him, too. So you got to make sure Matthew does not see that. But good guy Matthew is taking care of him.
So how is your son doing?
He's okay.
Yeah? That's good.
He's not okay.
Hmm.
Brain dead anti-vaxxer got him sick. Horrible life. Threatening virus.
He's not. He is like totally closed off. I just feel like it's gonna make him even that more unreachable.
Mm-hmm. Well, love's gonna start feeling bad for him because he's opening up to her.
How did I end?
Dude, okay, the actor that's playing Matthew from the side in like far away shots, he looks like Anthony Starr, the dude who played Homelander. Not so much right here. But from like the side, yes. I would have loved it if this was Anthony Starr, though. That would be so lit. See, like, he's acting in a very similar way. I feel like Anthony Starr would do such a good job in this role, too. Has like the really good demeanor for it. Like that right there.
There's like that look again.
Yeah, like these in, like these really intense stares.
Talking to you about going to visit her sister?
Or he doesn't know anything. He's just hoping I can help him find his missing wife. Is it possible Matthew's a nice guy?
What's wrong with your son?
He's sick, too. He's in the hospital.
He'll become dads all kinds of ways. I was even kind of excited about it, and Theo was a great kid. But I was young and extremely ambitious. I was a shitty stepdad, and he hated me. But now his mom's remarried, new family, and Theo hates her even more, so he's come back around here. Most of the time, I still have no idea what I'm doing.
But he's trying.
All I know is that he needs me, just like your son needs you.
Aw, that's making you cry.
I'm sure she's fine. She's done this for attention, and now she's too embarrassed to come home. You don't think anything's happened to her, do you?
What have we done, love?
Yeah.
I want to help, but say this thing. Is to let him stay silent and hang himself in the court of public opinion.
They're not gonna be able to frame him now. He's too good of a guy. Henry's fever just broke.
He's okay.
Okay, good, good.
And I promised him I'd be a good man, worthy. I cannot frame an innocent man. I can't do it.
But you're not talking to the press.
I don't care about the press.
You should. Don't tell your story. They will tell it for you. You can't be there for Theo if you're behind bars.
Now love's gonna be like, what the fuck do you mean? What are we supposed to do? Blah blah.
Oh no. I didn't realize you were sick too.
Yeah, love's gonna be pissed. She realizes it was Joe that got him sick.
We'll get home safe. Don't wanna find you passed out by the trash again.
You leave the scarf by the trash? I don't know why I did this. Like, you gotta make sure you grab that. That scarf. Don't forget about it. Cause if Matthew finds that, he's gonna know.
I took it back. Matthew's a decent man. He already lost his wife. If we send him to prison.
What kind of people would we be? We're better than that.
Not really, because you still killed Natalie, but like.
What does it mean?
I feel like that would ruin your sink. Fucking Jerry, dude.
Let's go. Come on.
I don't think Matthew wanted to look even guiltier, but not showing up to your wife's vigil.
Yeah.
Matthew. Oh.
No, it would mean a lot to Natalie to see how many people came out here tonight.
It wasn't a strategy. He waited so long because he almost couldn't do it. Mm-hmm. It's that hard for him to talk about her.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
Because he cares.
Please come home or let me know you're okay.
He looks like a mix between Anthony Starr and Ed Norton. And he sounds like Ed Norton.
If God forbid somebody out there has done something to my wife,
I will find you. I will kill you.
And you will be punished.
Oh.
That's it.
Contrary to popular belief, it's not.
Sorry, I didn't break down and fall to my knees for you, Sherry. Sorry.
We found the ring.
She left it on the sink in the bathroom on purpose, yeah. Probably shouldn't have left that there anyway.
Sure I didn't die last week.
Unnecessary, thank you. I'm glad you're feeling better. If you'll excuse me, I'm actually expecting a call.
He's just like really closed off, so he comes off like a weirdo, but it's like a super hardcore introvert.
Were they sick?
Not anymore, but they both had it. Can't tell you how sorry we are for exposing Henry.
Love's gonna fucking hate them though.
He's had measles?
Margaret really regrets not saying anything when you called. I think she was just stunned to hear that Henry had to be hospitalized.
Yeah, that's why she hung up.
It won't hold it against us. You see, we just don't
Love's gonna kill them. Love's gonna
injections they don't need to fight things their bodies were created to fight. We don't.
Oh, Love's killing them. Love's killing them. Her blood is boiling.
The most important thing is that everyone is better now, right?
Hey, Gil.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Love. Motherfucker. I didn't think she'd do it right now. Thought she'd do it like in the next episode. God damn it, Love. Oh my god. We can't kill everyone. So that was season 3, episode 3. But now, Henry got sick, he got the measles. And the kids gave it to Joe and Henry because the kids weren't vaccinated. And that ticked off Love really badly. She's a very protective mother. She was ranting about like anti-vaxxers and stuff, and she was reading that thing on her phone about it too, right before he walked in and confessed that, hey, it was actually our kids that gave it to Henry. And that tipped her over the edge, you know? From Love's perspective, it's like, well, the fact that he didn't vaccinate his kids against the measles could have killed her son Henry. So I get the frustration part of it. Yeah, I mean, like, if I had a kid and my kid got sick like that, and a chance for my kid to die, I'd be pretty pissed too. But I don't think she's gonna kill him. That's just her being her and like her going over the edge and killing him as a result of it, because she's a very protective person over the ones that she loves. So, okay, well, now we gotta cover this shit up. We can blame Natalie's death on him now. That's okay, because he's dead, but then how are we gonna explain his death? Or we gotta link both their deaths back to someone else now, a third person. So we gotta frame a third person. This is just a mess, dude. This is a mess. Joe is gonna be pissed again, dude. Okay. Joe's love for Love came back, and now it's gonna be gone again because she killed a cat. He's like, motherfucker. He's gonna be so mad. And then I think eventually Joe just gets fed up with it and he kills Love because he like sees her as a monster, and like she cannot be trusted to not kill anyone again. She's gonna get us caught up, and this is gonna directly affect Henry's life, because if we get caught for murdering people, Henry's gonna get sent to Child Protective Services, and then Joe's gonna be like, he's gonna grow up like me, and then he's gonna have a really bad life, and I don't want that. So Love must be dealt with. Eventually, I think that's what's gonna happen. I mean, maybe Joe ends up framing Love for Natalie, and well, he wouldn't be framing her because she actually did it. So maybe he's just like, yeah, Joe just gets super fed up and he's like, you know what, I'm ratting on her, I'm ratting her ass out or whatever, because she needs to be dealt with. But I think he'll definitely throw her ass in the cage or something, but then she'll be able to get out because there's a hidden key or whatever, and then she'll get him in the cage, but then he'll be able to get out because he hit his own key. So it's just gonna be a shit like that. And Joe can't rat her out. He can't send her to the jail or something because she'll just rat on him. So it's like, okay, he has to kill her. And so Joe's gonna have to set it up to where he kills Love, but also she gets caught for murdering Natalie and Gilly. And Gil, I think his name was Gilly, for killing both of them. So okay, that's where I think the season's leading to. So, but anyways, that was season 3, episode 3. Comment down below what you thought about this episode down below in the comments. And if you liked the video, like the video. And thanks for watching.